Hi, I'm Divyaa Pandit, your tarot card reader, spiritual healer and life coach. So here I'm coming today with a special video on making a nice talisman like I had made before for business and clients to attract more money and clients. I'm going to be sharing something that is a little magical. Well, I am not a Wiccan. I am not a person who is into Wicca or spell work or anything like that. But anything that is beneficial from that side, I get it here. And I use it myself and I share with everybody on YouTube. Even on my Facebook page, on my live videos, I share a lot of such knowledge. So basically, I am a researcher. I research, I gain knowledge, I take up courses every month. I'll at least 10 courses a month I take so that I can, you know, share everything with everyone. I do magical courses also, and because of which I have, gained a lot of knowledge about spell work and, you know, how to protect yourself, how to manifest money and things like that. So now I want to share with everybody a very nice little spell, or rather it's a very safe spell to use for yourself, because everybody has a right to protect themselves. And as we know that there are, you know, a lot of weird kind of people around us who have a lot of negative thinking. Maybe somebody can't see your progress, somebody can't see you growing, somebody can't see how pretty you are. So just to protect yourself, see, you have a right to protect yourself, you don't have a right to harm anyone. So just to protect yourself, you can make this small little cute talisman, which you can keep it at home, office, or you can carry it with you. Like last time I had made a jar with cinnamon and magnets and, you know, pyrite and everything in it. Today I'm making something that is very different, more of like a hoodoo Wicca sort of a knowledge, which I have, but right, like I said, I don't use. I only use it to benefit others and to protect myself. Like, I'm a YouTuber and I am growing each day. So there are so many people who don't want me to grow, who want me to come down. They could be family members, they could be outsiders, they could be anyone. So I have a right to protect myself. Same way, you all have a right to protect. So now we are going to start with a small little spell, a talisman that you can make to protect yourself. Well, I could have put this in a course, but I didn't, because I thought that instead of putting it in a course and earning money out of it, I feel sharing this knowledge will benefit so many people, and that is what I desire. I'm a giver by nature. So now what I'm doing is, first I am going to burn my Palo Santo, which I use. This is a piece of wood that comes from Mexico. It's a part of a tree. It smells absolutely amazing. It's a very sacred tree that it comes from, and it cleanses the energy. So if you don't have a Palo Santo, just burn some camphor, or you can just burn some sage to cleanse the energy. And if you don't have anything, just take salt. Salt is the best cleanser. You can just use some salt water, clean the space, and sit down to do what I'm doing right now. Just observe carefully. So first I will use my Palo Santo, because right now, before I start anything, we need to just cleanse the space. Okay, here I have lit my Palo Santo. Okay, now I am going to clear the energy first. Anything that is unwanted around me or the space should just go away. I am just clearing anything that is unwanted over here. Nobody is allowed in the space, because I'm doing something sacred to protect myself. Yeah, so I'm going to keep this here. So okay, now I'll just shift it here so that the smoke does not disturb the recording. So here I have this small little jar. You get this very easily in any shop. Okay, I'll open this jar now. Now, I've already cleansed this jar with salt water. I've taken salt water, I've boiled it, I've put it in, like how you sterilize bottles, same way I've sterilized it. Now, I will take this. The first thing that I'm going to do is, why have I kept Merlin here? Because Merlin is a lord of magic. He's going to help me in this spell. And he's a very kind-hearted, master who will always guide you. Right? So what you need is over here. You need any dark color candle. It could be a black candle. Right now, I'm here using Merlin candle, which is a brown color candle. Merlin is... energy is connected to brown color, so brown is Merlin candle. You can use a dark blue, you can use a black, you can use any kind of dark color. Okay, you can take this also. You'll find it very easily. You can get it online, or you get, you know, black candles outside churches also. Churches are the best place to find candles. So here from my stationery, I have called for these thumbtack needles. You know these thumbtack which you put it on the board, these thumbtack, right? These thumbtack needles. You can also use normal nails, which we do in that carpentry or in wall that we use. Normal silver nails will do. Small ones you take, you can put that. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a few. You don't have to count, you have to do it intuitively. You just have to put a few of these. Why am I putting these? These are pointed things, right? So anything that you want to cut, either you use a knife or use something pointed. Pointed always will cut off the negative energy. So the intention here is, any spell that you do, you have to do it with a very, very strong intention. Here these pointed things are going to cut off anything that is negative around me. Anybody who's trying to harm me is going to go away. And if it is a black magic or any kind of, evil eye, it will be cut off right now, this minute. And I'm going to say this every time I put these. I don't know, I feel like putting more, so I'm putting more. If you feel like putting less, put less. Use your mind, use your intuition. Anybody who's trying to cut me off will get cut off. I'm not trying to harm people here, but I am protecting myself. Okay, I'm just protecting myself. I've put these needles. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add a little herbs. Now I have sage here. I have, hibiscus, rose, lavender. Here what we need, the ingredients, I'll tell you. Here we need some mint. Now, mint is a very good protector. Here, I don't have dried mint, so I'm using fresh. Anyways, fresh mint will also get dried. So, here I am using mint leaves. Mint leaves really gives you a lot of protection. So, even eating mint is very healthy as it is. So, I'm going to break a little bit because the leaves are big. Okay. I'm also using basil. Basil leaves. Right, basil leaves are very easily available nowadays. You get dried basil also. You can use dried version also. Not necessary. If I'm using fresh, you have to use fresh. I'm using fresh basil leaves over here, and these fresh basil leaves are going to act as protecting me. Basil, please protect me. I'm putting some basil leaves here. Okay. Now I am going to put some cloves. Cloves are very good for repelling negative energy. Even if you put clove oil, or what you do is take one clove and stick it, as you press the clove on the candle, it gets stuck. So you start pressing cloves on your candle and then burn it on Saturday to repel negative energy. It beautifully will work. So I'm putting a few cloves in it. And this is ginger powder. This is ginger powder. I'm using ginger powder. I didn't get a spoon, but I'll put it with my hand, a pinch. Spoon is not necessary, because the more you use your hand, actually, it's better, because you're putting that personal energy in it. See, I'm putting ginger powder. Now I'm putting cinnamon powder to remove the blocks. Right? Cinnamon powder. Now, here you can either use sunflower petals, okay, dried sunflower petals. You can use dried violet petals. These are the two options for flowers. I am personally using hibiscus. I connect with hibiscus and I keep hibiscus also because I make a lot of mojo bags for people for protection and to, you know, protecting against evil eye. Then I make it for success, I make it for good luck. So I'm using this hibiscus dried flowers as I already have them at home in this. Okay, I'm inserting this inside. Okay, here. So this is done. The other thing I would personally like to use, as I have clove oil, I can add that also. But here I want to add frankincense oil. So this is optional. If you don't have frankincense oil, do not worry. This is my personal thing, that frankincense oil I really love and I really trust. Something that I trust in. So if you feel that you have something else that you want to put, intuitively you can add that. Okay, now things are done, my everything is done. But last thing that I would like to put, I am putting a little water in it. So in what you have to put, see, we don't have rainy season as yet, but if it is raining in your city, you collect a little rain water. I live in Mumbai, the rains have not started yet, but when the rains will start, I'm going to fill up a, you know, bottle of rainwater and keep so that I can use it in my talisman. Rainwater is very, very beneficial for such spells. But what I'm going to use, even if you don't have rainwater, I'm just going to put an intention. This water is going to manifest whatever I am going to ask. I'm going to add a little water in this. Few drops, you don't have to put like a lot, okay? I'm putting a few drops of water in it. Done. Now my technical part of the talisman is done. I am going to tightly lock it. You can use an airtight jar also. This is almost airtight. Okay. Last but not the least, what am I going to do? There is my matchbox here. I am going to light my brown candle. You can use any color, like I said. I'm going to keep it like this. Oops. No. Wait. I'm a very clumsy person. Divyaa the healer, the most clumsy person. Okay. So here I want to light it. So I am going to okay, I have lit this candle. Now I'm going to hold it and I'm going to, while I am dropping this wax on the talisman bottle, I am going to start putting my intention, and Merlin is right here. I am going to call upon Merlin. If you want, you can offer a chocolate to Merlin, because chocolate is very, very dear to Merlin. He loves chocolate. So you can offer a piece of chocolate to him and a little water, right? I didn't have chocolate right now, so I did not keep. Chocolate and water you can keep for Merlin, and then you are going to start concentrating on the candle. And you're going to pray and you're going to say your intention out loud, that I want to protect, rather I will put it, I am protected by the divine force to bring me the divine guidance, protect my house, my family, my work, my business, my money, any evil eye, any negativity, any black magic should be banished right now. You understand the tone of my voice? It's more like a commanding voice. Right now, I want it to banish right now. Why am I raising my voice? Because that actually is the internal force that I'm getting it right now, right now. I want it right now. Any negativity around my children, my house, my work, everything should be banished right now, this minute. Now let the whole candle burn out. The whole wax is going to cover the candle. As it starts coming down, the wax is going to come down on the small little bottle that you have made this. And as it covers, that will be the protection and the sealing point of your talisman. You are actually, by the wax, you are sealing the whole bottle to make something that you will use for protection for your house and family. The other thing that you can do is you can make two. One, you can keep it at home, and one, you will carry it with yourself. If you are a person who travels a lot, if you are a person who is into travel business, or your job demands to be traveling all the time, you can carry it with you. That is no harm. You can put it into a nice soft pouch and carry it with you. Soft pouch will always throw out, instead of a hard pouch, the soft one will always throw out the energy and keep you protected all the time. See, we on YouTube, when I make so many videos, people keep asking me this question, how do we protect our... This is a very good... You will not need any astrologer. You will not need any Wicca person. You will not need anybody. If you are making this small little jar yourself, because your personal power counts the most. This jar is already throwing out so much of energy. I can actually feel the pins going... you know, like this, making a nice big protection ball around me. I can actually feel it, believe me, I can. So this has already started manifesting and throwing out that energy, and I'm actually feeling it so intensely. Anyway, this is really good. So I hope you understood the whole spell, and if you are confused, I will be putting up the spell on the description box below. I will make it a point to put it so that everybody can read it and, you know, repeat it there. Because people have been messaging me, they can't follow what I'm saying, or maybe, I don't know. I'm trying my best to explain. But definitely, either I will put it on the video itself, or I will put it down in the description box. I'll see. I'll ask my digital company how it goes and how it will be. So please follow this. This is very intense what I'm sharing with you, because this is something which is taught either in hoodoo, or this is taught in Wicca and people who do a lot of spell work. I took so many courses to create or think which one will be the best for my viewers. And as you all can create this beautiful energy, which is actually, I can actually feel those pins running around me and, you know, creating that protection. I'm actually feeling it. It's beautiful. Believe me, when you make this yourself, instead of asking a healer to make it for you or asking a spell person to make it for you, you will feel that energy. And I want you all to feel that energy, because it is amazing. You will see how it works. I mean, how. Okay? So that's all. This is what I wanted to share with my viewers. And see you next time with more videos. I am coming up with more videos, Hindi and English both. Same topic will be Hindi, same topic will be English. So do subscribe my channel if you want more information. Do not forget, because I will get angry if you don't. So please like my Facebook page also, White Light Healing Center with the same name. It has a lot of more information on that also with my live videos. And email me for personal paid appointments on White Light Healing Center with a ER @gmail.com. That's all for today. Goodbye. God bless.